It's no secret that narcissists need to control everything. They need to control everything you do, say, think, like. But why is this? What is it about pathological narcissism that causes narcissists to need to control everything you do? Welcome to Looking Behind the Mirror, where we explore narcissism and take our lives back as we make sense out of nonsense. As a quick disclaimer, everything I say is based on my opinions and my personal experiences. I'm not a professional, and if you're really struggling, I encourage you to seek professional help. I am providing links below for you. In this video, I'm going to go over several reasons that pathological narcissists feel this overwhelming need to control everything about your life. Why they feel like they have the right to meddle in the affairs of other people and turn people into a sort of puppet for themselves. So let's jump right in. The first reason is that narcissists have an extremely black and white view of the world. So to them, they think that if they're not controlling other people are going to be controlling them. It's a control or be controlled, black and white kind of thinking or view. So if they're not controlling you and every little thing you're doing, obviously that means that you're going to start controlling them and every little thing that they're doing. Because in their mind, somebody has to be completely controlling somebody. We can't just all live in harmony where we all just do what's best for ourselves as long as we're not hurting anybody else. We can't be free to express our own identities or our own opinions or to have our own preferences. Somebody's gotta be controlling somebody else. So if they're not controlling you, you're gonna be controlling them, and they can't have that. They also do this because of projection. So it's not just because they have this black and white view, but they're also projecting the way they feel onto other people. So if they feel like they gotta control everybody all the time, they're assuming that you probably feel that way too. So again, if they're not controlling you, if they're not beating you to the punch, you're probably going to do that to them. You're going to be controlling them. And that's why they got to make sure that they're in control of you and they've got you under control before you get a chance to control them the way they know that you really want to, or you really would if you had the chance. So I guess you could call it a sort of paranoia. And that's why they feel this need to control everybody before anyone gets a chance to control them. Another reason that narcissists have to control everybody is they feel entitled. Entitlement is a very prominent feature of pathological narcissism. Narcissists feel pathologically entitled to direct everyone they know, everyone they see. They feel like they have the right to tell everyone what they should be doing with their lives. The world revolves around them, and they dictate reality, so they have every right to tell you what you should do with your free time and what you should like and what kind of music you should listen to and what you should be talking about, what kind of TV you should be watching. They have the right to tell you what to do with your life because they're pathologically entitled to whatever they want. Narcissists are extremely self-centered to a point of pathology. They deeply feel a strong conviction that the world revolves around them and that you exist to serve them. You exist for them. The only reason that you exist is to do stuff for them, or how you pertain to them, or what your relationship is to them. You don't exist for any other reason. You don't exist for yourself. That doesn't even make any sense to a narcissist. So to a narcissist, if you really care about them, or if you are loyal, or if you really love them, of course you're going to do anything they want anytime they ask. If you were to try to do something on your own for yourself that takes away from their resource, which is you, you are a resource that they own, that they're entitled to. If you take away from this resource by doing things for yourself, things that don't serve them, they feel like they've been robbed and betrayed. They feel like, how could you do this to me? I thought you cared about me. How could you spend time with your friends when I wanted you to spend time with me? How could you spend time watching a movie that you like when I wanted to watch a movie I liked? You're taking that away from me. How could you do that? I thought you cared about me. And because they're narcissists, it never occurs to them that things go both ways. Their lack of empathy precludes them from putting themselves in your shoes and thinking, oh, well, what about when I want to watch the movie I want to watch? Maybe this person would rather watch a different movie, but they're watching the movie I want to watch because that's how relationships work. And maybe I should let that person watch the movie they want to watch sometimes because that's fair. They don't look at it that way. It doesn't even occur to them. They think, I want to watch this movie I want to watch, and I should be able to do that because I'm entitled. And if anybody wants to watch a movie I don't want to watch, that's just taking away from my time. That's showing me that they don't care about me at all. Another reason that narcissists have to control everything is because they're delusional. They have a delusion that they're already in control of everything. They really feel like the whole universe revolves around them. And as I was referring to earlier, they look at you as an extension of themselves. They look at you as somebody that exists because of them, for them. Narcissists look at their life as a play that they are writing, a story about them, a movie that they are the star of, and you are an actor or an extra or a character in this story that they are writing. They dictate reality. Their fantasy of what they want their life to be about, this epic tale, is something they have every right to create, and you're supposed to play along with it. You're supposed to cooperate because you're not an autonomous human being with your own story. You're only a character in the story about them. So any deviation from that is really quite threatening to them. They feel threatened by the reality of autonomous people because people are supposed to only exist for them, supposed to only exist to be a character in the story about them. It's kind of like if you owned a television set, the narcissist looks at you as something they own, as a television set. Let's say you own this television set and this television set starts changing its own channels and adjusting its own volume, independent of what you want to watch and independent of the volume you would like to listen to what you're watching at. The TV makes its own decisions and does whatever it wants. And sometimes it lets you watch the show you want to watch, and sometimes it just decides to change the channel in the middle of what you're watching. That would be really, really frustrating and annoying, and you'd probably get a different television set if that was happening. Narcissists look at you the same way. You're an extension of them. They own you. They have the right to tell you what show you should play for them because you only exist to serve them. So when you start changing the channels or adjusting the volume to what you want to express at the volume you want to express it, they feel really threatened by that because the whole way that they perceive reality is being threatened by that. They don't operate in the real world. They operate in a fantasy world, and they don't like being confronted with the reality that sometimes you have your own preferences, and sometimes there are things that you would like to do or things that you prefer or opinions you have that don't have anything to do with the narcissist or his epic tale. Another part of this same delusion is the delusion that they create reality. Narcissists feel like their feelings and wishes magically manifest reality for them. So whatever they think, whatever they believe, becomes true because they think and feel and believe it. And what objective reality actually is doesn't matter, is not as important as what they feel reality is. I was going to say objective reality, but it's no longer objective because narcissists don't care about objective reality. So for somebody that feels, that actually feels like they have the power and the right to create reality out of their feelings, they can feel very, very threatened by the idea that people are able to make independent decisions and actions contrary to what they would like to see. That's very threatening to a narcissist. Another reason that narcissists have to control everything is that they feel personally insulted by your preferences. The world revolves around them, remember? So anything that you do is directly related to the narcissist. If you're just sitting there listening to music that you like, that is directly related to the narcissist if the narcissist is present. So the narcissist is going to take that personally, even if it has nothing to do with anything they're doing. So If you are sitting there listening to music that they don't like, they're going to start getting thoughts in their head of, why is she listening to music I don't like? There's something about that that has to do directly with me. So what is it? Well, she must be trying to insult me. She must be trying to bother me and annoy me. Why else would she be listening to that music? Because it doesn't really occur to them. Oh, maybe she just has different preferences. Maybe she just likes music that I don't like, and maybe that's okay. No, because anything you're doing relates directly to them, so you must be doing it to annoy them. You must be doing it on purpose to bother them. Or even worse, you must be trying to send them a message that their taste in music is wrong. Because narcissists can't really allow people to just have different opinions. Narcissists' opinions are correct. Narcissists' opinions are facts. Their feelings are facts. And so if you have different opinions, well, your opinions are facts too. And if they're contradicting with a narcissist's facts, one of you has to be right and one of you has to be wrong. And if your opinion is different, you must be trying to tell the narcissist that their opinions are wrong or stupid or whatever. So this is why narcissists can feel personally insulted by seeing or hearing things that they just, in their opinion, they don't like or prefer. And so just listening to music that they don't like in front of them might be taken as a very deep personal insult. And so this naturally translates into trying to control everything you do, into getting angry at you for listening to certain music and telling you that you can't listen to that. Even if you put your headphones on, they still feel insulted knowing that you're listening to music they don't like. This can lead to a life where in your own home, you've got to kind of sneak around with the music you like to listen to, or you might feel embarrassed watching the shows that you know you're not supposed to watch, being ridiculed and made to feel like you're the stupid one for liking certain television shows, being made to feel like you're doing something wrong, that your opinions are objectively wrong. This can translate into just preferences of how to do normal things. Maybe you like to sleep with the bedroom door open and they like to sleep with it closed. Maybe you need all the lights off to sleep and they don't. Maybe you need some white noise. Maybe you like to dust before you vacuum or vacuum before you dust. Maybe you wear your shoes in the house and maybe they leave their shoes by the door. I mean, there's arguments for why you should or shouldn't do these things, but whatever it is, your way becomes wrong, their way is right, and you don't have the right to decide for yourself how you prefer to do things because those always turn into insults. Another reason that narcissists have to control everything you do is because it confirms to them that they are the most important thing in the universe. It confirms to them that they are the only important thing in the whole universe. Nothing else even matters at all. So if they're able to control you and control everything that everybody does, that creates that supply that they need, that creates that feedback that they need, that reassures them, yeah, you're the only thing that matters. Yeah, you really are the center of the universe, and that's why these people are doing what you say. It's not because you're terrorizing them or because you've got so much power and influence over them, they really don't have a choice. It's because you are the most important being that has ever existed in the history of the earth, obviously. That's why you've been able to get these people to reassure you that you're so relevant, so powerful, so important. And this also confirms to them that they have control over their own life. If we remember the first reason, control or be controlled. If a narcissist can't control everybody else's life, it makes them feel like they don't have any control over their own life. And who wants to go around feeling like they don't have any control over their own life? So they really have to control everybody else's life or feel like they're controlling everybody else's life in order to feel like they have control over their own life. So if you are going around trying to make your own decisions, stand by your own opinions, do things your own way, that makes them feel like they're losing control of everything. If they can't control you, they've lost control of everything. If they can't control you, you're probably going to end up controlling them. So they feel very unsafe and unstable and unimportant and irrelevant if they can't nitpick and micromanage every little thing that you do. And I want to add here, how can you have a healthy relationship with somebody that actually feels unsafe and unimportant if you have your own preferences, if you would like to just watch your own TV show now and then, or maybe engage in a hobby that doesn't directly influence or relate to them? How can you have a healthy relationship with somebody that feels threatened by your own identity? And of course, one more big reason that narcissists have to control everything is because they have to control you in order to keep control of you. So I've already explained several reasons why they have to control everything you do. They have to add another layer to the top of that to keep control of the control that they have. And what I mean by this is, for example, they need to control the people that you talk to. So they're going to encourage you to break off relationships from people that might be helping you to maintain your own individuality. Because if you are talking and communicating too much with healthy people or people that are encouraging you to engage in healthy habits, that's going to give you some reference. That's going to help you start to see, hey, this isn't right. This person's controlling every little thing I do. It's going to help you break away if you have healthy connections with people that are going to help you identify these things. So narcissists are going to try to cut you off from relationships and information and just really anything that might clue you in to how badly you're actually being treated and how controlled you actually are. Another way they do this is knocking down your self-esteem, or gaslighting you, making you feel disoriented, really chipping away at your ability to trust yourself, to trust your own judgment, putting you in a position where you would rather lean on what the narcissist says than to make your own decisions, because they've gaslighted you into believing that you really can't make a decision on your own. You're always choosing the wrong things. This might go back to just listening to music. Maybe they've convinced you over time that you can't even choose good music. Your opinions are so off base. Your tastes are so out of whack. You can't even trust your own judgment. Something's wrong with you. You need to listen to the narcissist to know what music is good, or how to clean the floor the right way, or how to put toothpaste on your toothbrush the right way, or whether or not you should sleep with the door open or not, because your opinions are wrong. Your way of looking at the world is deeply flawed, and where would you even be without the narcissist? You wouldn't even be able to tie your shoes the right way. So this is another way that they control you in order to keep control, is convince you that you need to look to them. You can't even make your own decisions on your own. And this would be another thing that outside influence might help you see, might help you realize, no, you're perfectly capable of making your own decisions. And there is no right or wrong way to have the door open or closed while you're sleeping, or there's no right or wrong place to put your shoes at the end of the day. There's no right or wrong television shows to watch. You can decide what you prefer. You can have your own opinions. And I just want to say in closing that if you are in a close relationship with somebody that is narcissistic or has to control every little thing in your life, because of all these reasons that I've just explained, you can't control this. You can't explain this, because these reasons that pathological narcissists have to control everything are deeply, deeply ingrained in their psyche. If you try to explain to them why they need to let people do their own thing, all they're going to hear is a threat. They're going to hear somebody that's trying to undermine them, trying to take control of their own life away from them, and they are not going to hear what you say. They don't care how this affects you. They couldn't care less how annoying this is or how damaging it can be when they're chipping away at your sense of reality and your self-esteem. I would, of course, always recommend that you break off relationships like this, because they really are nothing but draining. I mean, this all just sounds exhausting, me explaining it. Living with somebody that has to micromanage maybe the way you talk, or the hobbies you have, or just every little thing you do, feeling like somebody's right over your shoulder, paying attention to your most minute movements and little tiny decisions day to day, that you're under the constant threat of being criticized and micromanaged and asked, like, what's wrong with you? Why are you doing it that way? That's really no way to live. But if you're stuck in that kind of situation, I know not everything's always so simple, not everything's always so black and white. And I would just try to play along with it the best that I could until I could find a way out of that relationship. If you're looking for a way to support my channel and you've been considering professional therapy, BetterHelp is offering 10% off of your first month of service if you sign up using the link below in my description. And if you sign up using the link below in my description, I will get a one-time commission. So that'll help me out and it'll help you out if that's something that you've been considering. I hope this helps. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment below any ideas you have for me for future videos or any questions that you have about narcissism that I might be able to answer for you. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you like this video and would like to see more like it in the future. Until next time, thanks. Bye.